class, we have discussed that there are certain changes that are taking place during a chemical reaction. So what are that changes that are taking place during a chemical reaction? Changes that took place when a chemical reaction occurs. First is change in temperature. You may find that in certain reactions, temperature increases and in others, temperature decreases when reactants combines to form products. So this can be divided into two parts: exothermic reactions and endothermic reactions. Exothermic reactions are those in which heat evolves out. And endothermic reactions are those in which heat is absorbed in by the reactants. Second change may be color change. You have seen in a reaction yesterday that when lead nitrate combines with potassium iodide, yellow precipitates were forming. So that can be quoted here as an example. Third change may be change in state. It is quite possible if you are taking reactant in the form of solid or liquid, product is gas, or it can be solid or liquid, some other state. So example here can be quoted like yesterday you have taken reaction zinc granules when reacts with HCl or say sulfuric acid, it forms zinc sulfate and hydrogen gas. So this reaction can be quoted in change in state, or there can be evolution of gas. In both you can give this example. These are the major changes that are taking place when a chemical reaction is occurring. So physical state may change, evolution of gas can be there, color may change, or temperature may change when reaction is taking place. Here also you can quote the same example. As in this reaction we have mentioned that heat is evolving out. And the reactions in which temperature decreases, like you are taking suppose ammonium chloride, it is dissolved in water. It forms ammonium hydroxide plus HCl. This is example of endothermic reaction. There are certain methods how you can make your equation, how to write a chemical equation. First thing is why we need to write a chemical equation. When you are saying magnesium ribbon is burnt in presence of oxygen to form magnesium oxide, if you will write it in words, magnesium ribbon burns in presence of oxygen to form magnesium oxide. It is quite a laborious method. It takes more time, more energy and even more space. So to reduce all the efforts, we can write it in the form of symbols. Magnesium burns in presence of oxygen to form magnesium oxide. Here left hand side is depicting reactants and right hand side is depicting products. This arrowhead is showing separation between two, that is between reactants and products. This is called chemical equation. In this we are writing in the form of symbols all the elements. This equation is unbalanced. Unbalanced equation is also called as chemical equation. Now this equation needs to be balanced. So we are writing here to make it balanced chemical equation. Now how this equation can be made more informative? If say you are having A plus B which turns to C plus D and you want to make this equation more informative, what information you can add in it? You can mention the state of substance. Say it is solid, you can write as L for liquid, G for gas, S for solid. If something is in the form of aqueous solution, you can mention it like this. Aqueous, like we have taken lead nitrate, aqueous solution. So we will mention here in square close bracket aqueous. After that, if reaction is exothermic, you can write plus heat. If reaction is endothermic on reactant side, you can write A plus B plus heat gives you C plus D, like this. If any other condition is there, say temperature 373 Kelvin, say pressure 200 atmosphere, or any catalyst is required. Catalyst is a substance which enhances the rate of chemical reaction. So you can mention here on the arrowhead. If reaction is going in both ways, then you have to put double headed arrow. This is half arrow shown on both sides, that is showing that reactant may turn to product and product may turn to reactant. This reaction can go in both ways. So it is reversible reaction. Keep in mind one thing. If forward reaction is exothermic, then backward reaction will be endothermic.